Okay, next. Punta naman tayo sa price elasticity or sensitivity of demand. So, elasticity. This is a measure. So, the price elasticity of demand is determined how? So, by computing for the percentage change. Okay, ito ah, percentage change in quantity demanded over percentage change in price. Yan kasi ang question eh. Ano bang change sa quantity demanded when the price change? Yon. Okay, so yun yung price elasticity of demand. Okay, so based on the result nitong price elasticity, we'll have if elasticity of demand is greater than 1, ang tawag natin dyan, elastic. Meaning, yung goods na yon ay sensitive sa price changes. Meaning, konting pagbabago lang sa price, malaki yung impact sa quantity demanded. Okay? If elasticity of demand naman is equal to 1, ang tawag dyan, unitary elastic. So, pag unitary elastic, insensitive to price changes. Meaning, kahit gaano magbago yung price, ganun pa rin yung mangyayari doon sa ating quantity demanded. Okay, insensitive siya to price changes. Okay? And if the elasticity of demand is less than 1, yun naman ay inelastic. So ito, not that sensitive to price changes. Okay? So kung may pagbabago sa price, konti lang yung change sa quantity demanded. Okay? So kasi hindi ko na nilagay dito, pero syempre meron din tayong concept ng perfectly elastic and perfectly inelastic. So ano naman 'yon? Yung perfectly elastic, okay? So ilagay mo dito sa taas kung nagno-notes ka, no? So perfectly elastic, so yun yung very sensitive. So very sensitive such that, okay? Ang ano kasi doon, elasticity of demand is equal to infinity. Ang nakalagay doon, ang denominator niya, 0. You cannot divide by 0. Anyway, meaning, walang change in price, pero, or minimal yung change in price, pero sobrang laki ng change in quantity demanded. Yun yung perfectly elastic. Okay? So, ayan. And then, meron din tayo dito class, perfectly inelastic. So, ano naman yung perfectly inelastic? If the elasticity of demand is equal to 0 naman. So, meaning, kahit anong mangyari sa price, di ba? Kahit anong mangyari, 0 pa din yung change in quantity demanded. Okay? Meaning, kahit gaano magbago yung presyo, binibili pa din. Okay? So, illustration. So, for example, we have Rico. Rico is a businessman selling t-shirts. The current price is 200 peso each for a piece of t-shirt and he sells 1,000 units on the average. If Rico decreases the price to 150 pesos each, so ano yan, sale, the quantity demanded increases to 1,500 units. What is the price elasticity of demand for the product that Rico is selling? And ano yan, yan ba elastic, unitary elastic, or inelastic? So let's see. So, tingnan natin sa table. So, ganito nangyari. Kung 200 daw yung price, 1,000 yung quantity demanded. So, this is the current level. So, kung ang price daw ay i-decrease natin to 150, ang quantity demanded is na 1,500. Okay? Kaso, kailangan natin percentage change. So, computin muna natin, ano ba yung change? So, for the quantity demanded, syempre meron tayong increase na 500. For the price, meron tayong decrease na 50. Okay, pero hindi yan yung kailangan natin. Ang kailangan natin, percentage change. So, paano ba nalalaman yung percentage change? So, the change divided by the old. So, 500 divided by 1,000, this is what? Increase of 50%. Okay, increase of 50%. And for the price, so 50 over 200. By the way, class, pag minesure natin yung elasticity of demand and supply later on, we are talking about the absolute value already. So, tanggalin na natin yung sign. So, 50 over 200, that is what? 25% decrease in price. Okay, so ano masasabi natin dito? 50% increase in quantity demanded for a 25% decrease in price. So what is now the elasticity? 50 over 25, 2.0. Okay, so ano meaning niyan? Rico's elasticity of demand is 2.0. So the demand greater than 1. So the demand for the products he is selling is what? Elastic. Yan, no? Konting change lang sa price, 25% lang, pero malaki yung impact sa quantity demanded. Yan. Malaki yung impact, 50% compared sa change in price, 25% lang. Okay? So yan yung elasticity of demand. Okay? Next, tingnan naman natin class, ano ba yung relationship between price elasticity? So itong kinumpute natin and the total revenue. Yan, total revenue nung seller. So yan. As we have three scenarios, 'di ba, yung ating elastic demand, inelastic demand, and unitary elastic demand or unitary demand. So yung price change natin, dalawang possible direction niyan, the price may increase or it may decrease. So dito muna tayo sa elastic demand. If the price increase, so nag-increase yung price, so syempre anong maiisip diyan ng mga buyers? Ako, tumaas ang presyo. Di syempre konti na lang yung bibili nila, bababa yung quantity demanded. By how much? Malaki or konti lang? Syempre elastic yan eh. So malaki yung change. So the total revenue will decrease. Diba? Kasi madami yung demand na mababawas or yung quantity demanded na mababawas. Okay? Oh, dito naman, the price decreased. So kung bumaba naman ang presyo, so ano naman ang reaction ng mga buyers? So syempre maraming bibili. So it will increase the quantity demanded. So maliit lang or malaki? Dahil yan ay elastic, malaki yung change. So it will increase the total revenue. Okay? Doon naman sa inelastic demand, so nag-increase yung price. So ganun pa rin yung reaction ng mga buyers, 'di ba? Mababawasan yung buyers kasi nga tumaas ang presyo, pero konti lang yung mababawas na buyers kasi nga inelastic naman 'yan. So the total revenue will still increase. Okay? O kung dito naman, kung bumaba yung price, so decrease. The price decrease, dadami yung buyers, pero konting buyers lang ang madadagdag. Okay? And then sa unitary demand naman class, okay, whether the price increase or the price decrease, there is no change in total revenue. Kasi 1 is to 1 lang yan eh. 1 is to 1 yung kanyang ratio. Okay? So tingnan natin class yung effect dun sa ating example kay Rico. Previously, yung quantity demanded niya 1,000 at a price of 200 pesos for a total revenue of 200,000. Okay? And since ano nangyari dito? Price decrease, di ba? From 200 to 150. And ano ba si Rico? Elastic, inelastic, or unitary? So siya ay elastic, di ba? Dito yan. So 15 times 150, 225,000. So ano nangyari sa total revenue? Di ba? Ito yan eh. Increase. Okay, so hopefully na-understand nyo yun ha, yung relationship between price elasticity and total revenue. Okay, class, kasi magiging useful yan sa managerial concept kasi, di ba, as a seller, so later on, syempre, meron kang pricing decisions na ginagawa eh. Diba? Tataasan ko ba yung presyo or ibababa ko ba yung presyo? So, syempre, you will consider, ano ba yung products na binibenta ko? Ito ba, elastic, inelastic, or unitary? Okay, para alam mo yung magiging possible impact sa total revenue. Okay?